newspaper is for you care or you pay more, the negative side of targeted promotions. And this is takeaway site from the Journal of Product and Brand Management, and is published in 2007. And there are four parts in programming content. First, introduction. Second, methodology. And conclusion. And finally, reflections. Okay, the introduction. The target promotion is the prices of offering different, is the practice of offering different prices to present and prospective customers. Such as the airline offer the promotion program for the people who are frequent flyer. And in the last decade, some studies try to examine how if consumers perceive unfairness based on self and other comparisons. However, no work has focused on both present and prospective customers' comparisons. Therefore, this paper is one to examine the perceptions of unfairness, cognitive and emotional outcomes shown by present versus prospective customers when faced with the target promotions. For the research design, there are experimental group and control group. And both of these groups have present and prospective customer. And under the experimental group, they have equality conditions for advantage and disadvantage with the 10 and 20% discount. And for the control group, they have equal conditions for 20% discount. And the total participants were 166 students involved in research. And they are aged from 18 to 23. The instrument will be used, the questionnaire. For the first hypothesis, they want to know, compare to the prospective customer, present customer have lower levels of perceived unfairness under the advantage conditions. So let's see the results. We can see in the diamond line here, the diamond line, the number of the present customer had no significant difference between the prospective customer. So the hypothesis is rejected. The possible explanation is that prospective customer had already been offered the advantage of price discount for a long period of time. Therefore, this in the marketplace. Therefore, this hypothesis is rejected. And the second hypothesis is that compared to the prospective customer, present customer have a higher levels of perceived unfairness under disadvantage conditions. And the results show that we can see in the square line here. The number of present customer have significantly higher than the prospective customer. Therefore, the hypothesis is accepted. And the third hypothesis is that perceived unfairness negatively influences perceived values, and thus perceived values positively influence purchasing intention. And let's see the result. We can see that perceived unfairness have negative influence the perceived value, and the perceived value have positively influenced the purchasing intentions.
So go back to slide 15 one more time, please, Marie. Let's review the hypothesis. Everybody to make the hypothesis. It's about negative emotions.
Yes.
So read the hypothesis one more time for us, please.
For the negative emotions parts, they want to know whether the perceived unfairness positively influence negative emotions, and thus the negative emotions will negatively influence purchasing intentions.
Okay. Thank you.
this one, the hypothesis one is one to focus on the perceived value. So I just show the wrong ability.
So if you mean three, hypothesis three?
You mentioned that you want me to show again the hypothesis four, hypothesis three.
Three.
Yes, could I show
three,
the hypothesis
yes,
four?
So the table following the hypothesis should be the table results slide 16.
So this is the result for the hypothesis three.
Yes.
And the next hypothesis is for the negative emotions. Mm-hmm. They want to know whether the perceived unfairness positively influences negative emotion, and thus negatively emotion will negatively influences purchase intention. And the results show that perceived unfairness positively influences the negative emotion, and the negative emotions had a negatively influences for the purchasing intentions.
Okay,
conclusions. Okay. When the target promotions favor prospective customer, the same customer will have strong perceived unfairness, and thus, in turn, the cognitive and the affectivity will reduce purchasing intentions for perceived value and the negative emotions. Therefore, the spatial attention should be paid to the negative side effects of the targeted promotions. And finally, the reflection. As I mentioned before, they have a control group and experimental group, and they both have 10 and 20% discount. And I think if this research could further provide the no discount conditions, it may help us to further know how did the price discount levels mitigate consumers' perceived unfairness.
So in other words, you say suggest that how many groups maybe we can study? How many groups? Three conditions.
One
is
experimental group, and otherwise control group.
Uh-huh.
And they both have a 10 and 20% discount.
Plus
and no discount conditions.
Good.
They will be further help us to know the perceived unfairness from customer.
Okay, thank you.